Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. My name's Nick, and in today's video we'll be talking about how to care for your new crested gecko. When you're getting a crested gecko, it's important to know where they're from. Little crested geckos like Waylon, who was my first, they are from New Caledonia. New Caledonia is a group of islands that is located between East Australia and Fiji. This island is also home to a multitude of other geckos, and we have a lot of species of, you know, New Caledonia geckos that come from there, such as the lychee, the chihua, the gargoyle, tons of our favorite geckos in the trade now. They come from New Caledonia. Crested geckos get their name due to the crests on their head. Waylon has a very pretty crest to show you here. They can also be called eyelash geckos because if you look at their eye, they have little eyelashes. How cute is that? Something really awesome about these little guys is that up until 1994, they were thought to be extinct. They were rediscovered and then they were slowly introduced back into the pet hobby and the pet trade, which is awesome for us now because they're one of the best beginner pets that you can get started with. And what's really cool about crested geckos is they come in tons of colors and patterns and things like that, which we call morphs. Now let's talk about the size of your crested gecko. If your crested gecko still has its tail, you can expect once it hits adult form to be about 8 inches from snout to tail, and about 4 inches from snout to vent. When we talk about sexual maturity in these guys, it's important to know that age and weight play a huge factor in this, and it's not just one or the other. You can typically expect them to reach sexual maturity at 15 to 18 months old. Now that's usually for the males. Your females you're gonna see will usually hit at about maybe 18 to 24 months is more likely. So once a male hits about 35 grams, that's when you know for sure that that male is sexually mature. Females, on the other hand, you should wait until they're at least 40 grams, and there are studies out there that suggest that you should not breed them until they're 2 years old, because I have females that can reach 40 grams in about that 15 to 18 month mark, so it's important to maybe wait a little bit longer if breeding is something you're interested in. When sexing your crested geckos, you can see that males have a very predominant bulge down here at the base of their vent. Now, some females are a little bit more bulgy than others, but at this age, you know, she's about 70 grams and 2 years old. By that time, she would have been showing a much larger bulge like Waylon if she was a male. Now, once they become sexually mature, they can develop into male as late as 30 grams. Now, that's very rare. Typically, they're going to drop between 18 to 20 grams. Now, let's talk about housing. For adults, the minimum that I recommend is an 18 by 18 by 18. Most people are going to tell you the minimum's an 18 by 18 by 24, and that's not bad. If you can go with an 18 by 18 by 24, go with it. You can put your juvenile in that. I never believed in the adage that you can't put a small crested gecko in a tank that size. They're going to find their food, and if not, find out where they're sleeping and put the food right by them so when they wake up, they smell the food. Like I said, 18 by 18 by 24 is probably preferred. If you want to go bigger than that, feel free to go bigger than that. The bigger is better for these guys, in my opinion. Crested geckos are arboreal species, so they like to be higher up than they prefer ground space. So anytime you're buying an enclosure for them or a tank or anything for them, just remember that they're going to prefer height over ground space because they like to be up in trees and that's naturally where they're at. One big tip that I would say on buying your crested gecko is don't buy a baby. Buy a juvenile that's well started. Probably something in that, I don't know, I'd say 15 gram range would be nice because at that point they are big enough for the 18 by 18 by 24. They will be fine in that. And also, at that point, you know that the gecko is well-started and it's healthy and you're investing in something that will more than likely live longer than maybe if you bought a hatchling, because hatchlings require a different set of care. And then now, a big part of this too is this house is expensive enough as it is already. So instead of investing in multiple tanks, maybe buy something that's big enough for you to put into so you only gotta buy one tank. And then maybe a couple years down the road, if you wanna upgrade, upgrade. That's awesome. Do that for your gecko. Now, one important thing to remember when we're talking about tank size is that these guys, believe it or not, they can live for 15 to 20 years. So that means that little Wheeze here is 2 years old. She's going to be with me until I'm, hopefully, you know, like 50 or 60. But in reality, I'll probably be in my mid 40s by the time that she would be at the age where she's going to pass. That's really exciting to me. So, just remember that when you're investing in these guys, understand that they are gonna live a long time as long as you're properly taking care of them, which I hope that you do. Okay, so let's talk about the lighting and temperature that your crested gecko is gonna need. Now, temperature-wise, the highest you should ever let it get is 84 to 85 degrees, and the lowest you should let it get is about 65 to 68. Now, in New Caledonia, the average temperature per month, I'll put up a little chart right here. As you can see on this chart, the highest it gets is 84, and the lowest it gets is 63. So as keepers, we need to emulate somewhat of what it is in the wild. The other thing that I want to talk about is lighting. So what's really interesting is in New Caledonia, and I'll put up a chart on the average sunlight hours that that the island gets per day in each month. I'll put that right here. Now, this is kind of crazy because I would assume that this is why these guys are nocturnal, right? Having at most 8 hours of sunlight in a day, you would have to hunt at night. So, which is important because our little guys are nocturnal, so they're gonna be most active at night. I'm sure that they adapted for that reason. I don't have anything to back that up, but it makes sense. If you do need additional heat, I would recommend purchasing a Fluker ballast, and then they have the ceramic heat emitter bulb. Now, you can tie it into a thermostat, and then that way, once the desired hot spot hits about 70, 72 degrees at night, it'll turn off. That way, you are protected from a fire or anything like that. That bulb won't get too hot, and it won't kill your little guy. It's okay to let there be a warm spot at the top of the tank. These guys are going to control their temperatures as they move up and down. So if they want to be cooler, let them go to the bottom of the tank. If they want to be warmer, they'll go to the top of the tank. Nighttime bulbs is kind of a controversial topic in a sense. Now, some people try to sell you a blue light. I do not use blue lights. If I had to use anything, I would use a ceramic heat emitter. Now, they say that blue lights don't mess with the lighting wavelengths that hit these guys' eyes. Dang! Even now, I don't know if that's true or not. My research that I did on this was kind of up in the air. I would err on the side of caution and not give them any light because I feel like mine are in the dark and they do just fine in the dark. So don't waste your time on a blue light, or especially don't do a red light or anything like that. Leave it dark. So now I want to talk about UVB. These guys, since they are nocturnal, they do not need UVB. You don't have to provide UVB. Now, there are benefits and there are studies that show that these guys do benefit from UVB. So that is something to consider. If you want to provide UVB, go for it. It's good for them and it's only going to help them. It's not going to hurt them. One thing that it does do that's very important is it will put them on a day-night cycle. So when that UVB is on, they know that the sun's out, so they're going to sleep. They will stay on a time schedule, and that's important. And then once it turns off, okay, it's nighttime. It's time to go out, hunt, and find food. UVB, you can do it. You don't have to. I recommend putting either like a plant grow light, or you can use a UVB strip bulb as well, and that will provide that day-night cycle. But also, it will help the plants grow in your tank if you want to do live plants. So that is something that can be twofold beneficial, and I'll link a couple fixtures in the description below. And a lot of the stuff I'm saying, I will be linking below to Amazon for you guys to see what it is. If you want to buy it off that link, great.